morning. I am so very sorry we can't be together this morning of all mornings. Once again, COVID has prevented us following our normal routine. But I'm reminded that this inconvenience is the smallest of inconveniences compared to the many, many sacrifices and sufferings given in the Second and First World Wars. I do hope that you will enjoy this wherever you are, and this gives you the opportunity to be part of the Aysgarth family on this very special day. I also hope that in a few weeks' time, we will be able to return to normal routine and welcome you back to this lovely chapel. We have Jonathan Anderson from Merkestone Castle visiting us on the 28th, and of course then we have our Advent and running into Christmas. As for this morning, I'll do my very best to guide you through a service. I hope you get a chance to have a view of the order of service. If not, bear with me, and we'll do my best to lead you. And with that in mind, if you can find sight of this, we can start our service this morning by standing for hymn number 537. It's O God, our help in ages past. We're going to sing verses 1, 2, 3, and 6. Stand up.
so have I loved you. Now remain in my love. If you keep my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. My command is this: love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you servants, because a servant does not know his master's business. Instead, I have called you friends, for everything that I learned from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you so that you might go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, and so that whatever you ask in my name, the Father will give you. This is my command: love each other. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We now stand for our second hymn, number 358, O God of Earth and Water. Stand here.
Crosses, row on row, that mark our place, and in the sky, the larks, still bravely singing, fly, scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead, short days ago, we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe. To you from failing hands we throw the torch. Be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep, though poppies grow in Flanders fields.
Choir
Headmaster, for inviting me to participate in this important service. And good morning to all the boys, the teachers, and the families of the Aysgarth community. Remembrance is about all people who have died and suffered because of war, both in the past and today. And it's worth noting that there are some 20 wars ongoing around the world today. And remembrance is not just about the soldiers, sailors, and airmen. It's also about ordinary people and families around the world. This morning, I'd like to share my thoughts and reflections about remembrance with you. What I think about every day and today in particular. I'd suggest that these ideas I will share with you are as relevant to you all as they are to me. And I invite you to think about them today and to reflect upon them as you grow through the school and beyond, seeing them perhaps as anchor points that you will benefit from personally, both at home and at school, and they will support you as you move onwards in life. Today's Bible reading said there is no greater love than to lay down one's life for one's friends. In these words, John is talking about service, the act of giving of oneself to others, sacrifice in time and through work, not necessarily giving one's life. So it is service that is the central theme that I reflect on when thinking about remembrance, because my motivation and the motivation of the vast majority of my fellow soldiers and officers is to make a difference, a positive difference through our service, to help others in the United Kingdom and around the world. This is not about being comfortable, sitting at home and watching the news on the television, but this is about stepping forwards and acting to support and enable those who are unable to themselves to make a positive change in the world. My medals that I wear on my chest and those that other servicemen and women and veterans wear may look like pieces of ribbon and tin, but they are far, far more than this. They represent our service and, for me, are a window into my 25 years of experiences. They offer a memory book of stories, of the people that I've met, the things that I have done, and the countries I have visited around the world. Across all of these memories that I reflect on, I want to share the four key ingredients of service which stand out for me. Firstly, is selfless commitment. This is, of course, the opposite of selfishness. It is a willingness to endure hardship personally and to always place others' interests above your own. Soldiering and service is a way of life and not just a job. It places huge demand on the individual and their families in the pursuit of a greater good. Crucially, though, the reward for selfless commitment is an incredibly powerful sense of self-worth drawn from helping other people. Second is courage. The most obvious thing that might spring to your mind when thinking about soldiers is physical courage or bravery. This, of course, is an essential ingredient of service. The requirement to face danger and immediate threats to your own life on a battlefield, to resist fear and to get on with your job. The same is true, and maybe of many of you, the first time you face a fast bowler on the cricket pitch, or the first game for the first 15 that you play on the rugby field. I've been fortunate enough to have the privilege of serving with thousands of incredibly brave men and women from armies across the world. And arguably, the bravest are those who have the least in terms of equipment and support available to them. Now, whilst physical courage is important, I place moral courage above the physical. This is all about having the courage to speak out, to challenge, and to stand up for what you believe in and know to be right, rather than going with the flow or being led astray. You will all have been there at some point in your life facing a T-junction of choices. There is a hard right turn, which may well be unpopular with your friends, or the easy wrong turn. And so service is all about taking the hard but right turns. Third is humour. When life is dangerous and difficult, it's easy to become downbeat, and maybe even for some depressed. Your teachers will, I'm sure, say there's a time and place for humour, and perhaps it isn't always in the classroom, but I can assure you, in my experience, that humour, jokes, and fun are a critical part of service. They lighten moods and ensure nobody becomes unnecessarily bogged down by the seriousness of any situation. Finally, I think about comradeship. This is the bond of brothers and sisters in arms across armies, faiths, and languages to endure danger and hardship and to look out for one another in good times and in bad. This is all about the value of teamwork, exactly as you all experience on the sports pitch. It is, of course, reliant upon trust and confidence in one another to know that others will look out for you in exactly the same way that you will do so for them. So, in summary, what of remembrance for me? I first wore a military uniform when I was 13 years old in the cadet force at my school. And over the subsequent 33 years, I've reflected a great deal. I've made many friends for life around the world from different armies through my work in uniform. I've had the privilege of learning continually as I've travelled and gained many lifetimes experiences, and I've used up a couple of my 9 lives on the way. But overall and importantly, this journey brings me back to the value of service and the critical components of selfless commitment, courage, humour, and comradeship. As you start your journeys in life, you may wish to think about them too.
I ask you please to stand for our act of remembrance. Let us remember before God and commend to his sure keeping those who have died for their country in war, those whom we knew and whose memory we treasure, and all who have lived and died in the service of mankind. We remember the old Aysgarthians who gave their lives for their country, the brave and true. A. E. Cathcart, R. Walmsley, R. A. Markham, D. R. Wilson, S. D. Forbes, J. L. I. Reed, H. G. Brooksbank, H. A. Askew, S. Brooksbank, C. G. W. Peak, J. J. Stovart, J. C. D. Brown, R. M. Torrin, G. E. Hunter, H. T. Hunter, G. P. Ledyard, C. N. F. Brown, W. F. Martin, C. F. Ward, W. P. Ord Pullett, W. A. Erskine, J. R. I. Hopkins, L.V. Burgoyne Johnson, N.C. Mapplehose, D.G.F. McBean, W.M. Parker, H.P.L. Hayworth, E.C. Chapman, A.V. Clegg, H.G.A. Moore, J.J. Kearney, R.C. Clegg, A.L. Ford, D.A. Beveridge, A.F. Chance, P.C. Preston, J.W. Backhouse, C.G. Sharp, M.I.D. Wyville, A.M. Slingsby, J. Burden, H. L. Benson, W. Adamson, R. Duca, C. G. Winter, D. W. O. Palmer, T. J. Whitney, C. Horden, R. E. T. Huddett, C. R. E. Edmondson, D. O. Lang, G. H. H. Scott, A. M. Thorman, H. J. Butter, R. P. Brown, G. N. Greenwood Teal, H. R. Pybus, G. S. K. Butterworth, C. Hall, S. J. Pearson, J. F. Brown, T. R. Fawcett, B. Bloomer, C. H. D. Mann, F. O. Treckman, H. E. Backhouse, R. H. Tolson, C. P. Taylor, A. D. D. Spafford, R. H. Smith, C. D. M. Ord, R. H. E. Hutton Squire, G. H. Lofthouse, G. O. Lang, J. H. Bose Wilson, C. F. Savage, S. I. Jefferson, T. T. Thorpe, J. C. D. Tetley, W. E. Littleboy, H. Q. Ridley, K. Glazeby, J. A. Harris, C. F. B. Simpson, H. M. Appleton, H. K. Mostyn Owen, J. K. M. Hestler, C. M. Williams, R. A. Wilson, F. A. W. Armitage, J. L. Kinnear, H. N. Constantine, A. N. Hessler, E. S. Chance, J. Tilley, L. O. Vavasour, W. A. C. Headley, R. L. Tully, W. L. Nimmo, F. G. B. Cobham, B. C. Harrison, C. H. Bell, G. Skirrow, C. G. Sutton-Jones, R. A. Horden, J. S. Pearson, N. E. Horden, H. J. N. P. Allenson, and in the Second World War, D. M. Agnew, W. Astle, H. D. Atkinson, J. G. Barton, J. M. Bennion, J. R. P. Dellisford, J. L. Della P. Beresford Pierce, A. C. R. Bross, A. H. Carruthers, W. H. D. Chapman, J. F. Cocking, P. M. Cocking, H. C. W. Davis, J. M. Elliott, R. C. P. Ellis, The Honourable A. S. Fraser, P. Graham, C. A. M. Grover, R. S. Harrowing, A. R. Huston, P. L. Ingham, P. C. James, J. Kennedy, M. R. Kitchen, W. L. S. Knox Gore, A. T. Lawson Tancred, J. H. Lewis, W. R. Marshall Adeen, D. Minutz Hagen, W. E. S. Paget, H. H. Pearson,
B.J. Pearson, N.R. Peel, L. Richmond, W.A. Robinson, C.G.A. Roach, J. Sample, W. Scott Plummer, W.G.C. Chevier, H.G. Wood, J.M. Smith, R.P. Stannard, J.A.F. Thompson, R.F. Thompson, R.K. Thompson, R.M.M. Tyndall, R.R. Tomlinson, R.P. Turner, D.C. Wallace, H.W. Woodsend, J.N. Whitworth, the Reverend G.A.K., L.F. Malone. They shall grow not old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. We will remember them.
Thank you. servicemen and women who have died in the violence of war, each one remembered by and known to God. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
For all members of the armed forces who are in danger this day, remembering family, friends, and all who pray for their safe return, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For civilian women, children, and men, whose lives are disfigured by war or terror, calling to mind in penitence the anger and hatred of humanity, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the peacemakers and peacekeepers who seek to keep this world secure and free. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all who bear the burden and privilege of leadership, political, military, and religious, bestow upon them gifts of wisdom and resolve in the search for reconciliation and peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Hear our prayer.
O God of truth and justice, we hold before you those whose memory we cherish and those whose names we will never know. Help us to lift our eyes above the torment of this broken world and grant us the grace to pray for those who wish us harm. As we honour the past, may we put our faith in your future, for you are the source of life and hope. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. God, our refuge and strength, bring near the day when wars shall cease, and poverty and pain shall end, that earth may know the peace of heaven through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us join together in the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. I ask you now please to stand for our final hymn this morning, number 355, if you have a hymn book, I Vow to Thee My Country.
Thank you.